She caught me on the counter.
Wasn't me.
Saw me banging on the sofa.
Wasn't me.
I even had her in the shower.
Wasn't me.
She even caught me on camera.
Wasn't me.
She saw the marks on my
shoulder. Good evening. Welcome to another episode of The Caribbean Edge. I'm Dawn Wilson.
I'm Keith Curran.
Sean Whittingham.
Sean Spaulding.
And welcome again, as tonight's topic is adultery.
Better known as BUN.
You cheat, you thief somebody's mind. So, proposing it to the panel tonight, and to you, our audience, you can comment. Have you ever cheated, one?
Been
accused of cheating?
Like
or stolen somebody's man or woman?
No, me a bread.
Yes, I am. Thank you. So, since you put it out there, you go first. Have you ever been accused of cheating, or have you cheated? It's a valid topic for us.
Well, since you asked, Don. Listen, of course, I've had events of transgression. I've had incidents of transgression in the past. How they were dealt with, you know, that's a whole another story.
You but frying pan over the head.
Yeah, well, if I took off my shirt, you could see the scars. But it really goes into we're gonna have to go into how everyone handles that, because I think a lot of people have experienced that. Either they've been on the side of the one who has cheated, or the one who has been cheated on, or both. You know.
So I kind of want to address something different, not so much a cheating, which I will come back and
so share. Like you, I escape. Why can't you get the same person as me?
No, the thing is, teeth people man or teeth people woman, I think it's impossible to do such a thing. I think if two people are in a relationship and a third person comes along, whether you cheat with that person or not, the people in the committed relationship, should one of them choose to leave, that is on their, that's on their own. The third party is not the one who, I mean, it's not caveman days where you tie up somebody and lift them over the head and drag them home with you. I mean, come on.
So basically nobody owns anyone.
Correct.
A wise man once told me, so Sean, you'll never own it, you know? You'll never own it. No matter what them tell you, you'll never own it.
Okay.
What is it?
Right?
What is it?
Yeah, as we move.
So Keith, have you ever stolen somebody's woman?
No, Shauna sit down beside him. It's Shauna next and then me and then you. So Shauna, have you ever stolen anybody's
woman? No, the answer is no. First of all, like I said, it's impossible to do such an act.
I said my things that then.
Well, have you been accused of stealing?
I have been accused, actually.
And?
And that's on them.
Okay.
No such thing.
Bruh.
Okay, so next.
No, I don't do them things.
Okay.
What do you mean you don't answer questions? I don't do them things.
Don't be with that. I don't do them things. Them things rough.
I did not inhale.
So like I escape about this.
Yeah? I didn't do them things. Wait,
next
about?
Week, Caribbean Edge with Houdini.
First of all, nobody don't own anybody, so I can't thief them, right? Right? So that's it. And then now, when you're talking about the cheat, if it never was, it never will be. Mm. So, there you go.
Wait, what do you mean
by that?
Bobby Boom Bell, watch this hand, watch this hand.
What have I ever stolen someone's man? I agree with the panel. You know, you don't own anyone, so you can't really steal them. Have I been accused of it? Yes. But I do live a respectful life where I don't put myself in the position. Of course, people hit on you all the time. Half of them are married or in a serious relationship. And so, you know, we in the Caribbean community, you kind of know everyone in the circle. And I try not to put myself in a situation to flirt with anyone's man. Or if they come at me, I'm the first to say no.
Right.
Now, have I been lied to that you're in a relationship? Absolutely. Mm-hmm. Have I fallen for it? Yes. But once I was convinced that you are truly lying to me, and I've done my own investigations. I'm not a stalker, but I wanted to know for myself and prove that you're truly lying to me, because I have someone telling me they're with you, mm-hmm. and you're denying it 100%. And men are good at it, because you can be with someone 90% of the time, and they never get a phone call. I don't have experiences with women, because I'm not dating I'm dating men.
Okay. Wait, but I have. Sure. I see opportunity in what you just said. I think we should start a new service, right? When a woman meets a man, or a man meets a woman, we take a picture, and then we create a meme and say, anybody with this person, you have about 72 hours to order.
She responds to the theme.
And if you don't, so which social media I think we should do that on?
All of them.
No, I'm a bit tired. We'll start an app. I'm going to follow that. Start a new holiday. So for every major holiday, Christmas, we're going to have December 24th, major Christmas. And then it's now February 13th, Mate Valentine's Day. What's that? Yeah. Can't take Mate to get leave out. It's not right.
Speaking of
Mate. By the way, that is Sean Spaulding.
S-E-A-N.
Spaulding@gmail.com.
Mate to them.
Speaking of which, Matey, good segue. How do you know you're a matey, whether you're a male or a female? Because this is a reason to understand.
I have a solution for that too. What you do is you get your man phone or you get your woman phone and call it. And if you see side chick or side nigga show up, you know you're the matey.
Or if you see Bank of America show up, it's your man. You know.
Oh, them know the tricks. Right, watch out. Or let me tell you, there's other tricks, you know. That sometimes when you're sleeping, and move your finger over your phone and then
things. Please divulge. Keep going.
Why are you so concerned?
No, I'm not telling the truth. There's some devious behavior going on here.
Especially
you see with them things. It's the smartphone and thing.
So how do you know you're a side piece?
You know, I think here's the thing. On a serious note, we're infinite beings. There's nothing you need to ask me that you don't already know the answer to. So whether it's staying quiet, meditating, or whatever, it'll come to you. But I think if your man cheated, I'm serious, I'm not joking, what are you laughing at? I think if your man cheated on you, you innately know, you feel it, you know. You some people stick around looking for the evidence. Oh, he's such a nice guy, he treats me so well. And they need to have it slap him in the
face.
They need to have it slap him in the face, but they know.
It's
sound like Buddha or Krishna was coming and saying, you know, you already know the answer. Well, some people just don't know, but I do agree. I agree with you. I think gut feeling. It means a lot. If you feel it.
So you think some people know?
Yeah, I think you know. You know.
Suppress it.
Yeah.
You know. Listen. One thing that separates us from animals is that we recognize patterns and we form patterns. And if your mate diverts from that pattern, that they
could, you know.
Listen, I'm gonna tell you. Let me share. You know, I, as a younger man, I used to make it a point to change my pattern. So if I always did something on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, I would change it up. Because in the event that something happens and, you know, I need to go sideways, something happens, then you can't look at me and say, well, you always do that. Something happened.
Right.
No, so you change it up. But the point is that you always change. There's a pattern that you adhere to. And
you know, someone using that strategy right now, and them a shout, and I say, what is this brother I have? I don't want to go. And them a mash it up.
No, man, fire for that for more. And try something different.
So, I'll ask the guys this question, because I think Keith's being very quiet on this. So is it true that men
buy new
underwear and stuff, so you can see some of the clues of that you're stepping out?
Wait, I know what? You said you have. Wait, what?
They go changed. Stuff changes. Like they buy new shirts, they start to work out more, they change their underwear.
But when they're cheating.
When they're cheating. Oh. So their pattern, like you said, has changed. Is that true?
You have to look at it this way, right? It's just like marketing. If you have a business and you have a certain thing going that you're selling, and you want to move into a different product, you have to change the way you market to sell it.
So I guess it's true because you're marketing to the side chick.
To the side chick. Oh, side chick might be different. So you have to change up like things. To find somebody who's going to be definitely like what you have, which sometimes is the attraction, that there's some similarity between what you have and the side chick, then there's just this nuance that you probably think is missing, or something that you're not getting, or some feeling that you didn't have, and you know, you don't definitely go out there and looking for it sometimes. You never know. You never know it happened. You don't know, because I have had friends who I spoke to, and it was I would never, you ever hear them say that word, I would never do this, I'd never do that, end up, and then fall right into it. It was an accident.
But that bring up a point that you made earlier that sometimes you're falling. I purposely use that word.
Falling is an accident.
Sometimes you're in a relationship and you love your wife or you love your husband and you don't feel or think that there's anything lacking, yet people still cheat. Well, and why is that?
There has to be. There has to be.
Even
if it's a fantasy. Even if it's a fantasy and you're like, wow, the opportunity for this fantasy is here, it wasn't there.
Well, I think it's a futile exercise for us to try and determine exactly what the reasons are. There's a multitude of different reasons for why people cheat.
Exactly.
And the question that begs is, are we monogamous creatures? Is that our makeup? Are we built for that? Because if you look at it, I mean, we all share a common ancestor. And this common ancestor comes from chimpanzees, and then we can go further back and whatnot. So if you look at that,
are chimpanzees faithful?
No, they're not. Oh. No, they're not. So it begs the question that is that really our makeup? Are we supposed to be monogamous? But there's also something else I wanted to ask, which is we're moving towards a secular society now, right? Where you have people that are exploring different faiths, people that are really questioning the faith that their parents had or whatnot. And how has that contributed to infidelity?
To your point about are we a monogamous society, what's interesting, I grew up in a dysfunctional family, even though I love them, I had an amazing childhood, but I grew up believing that I would get married, have children, be together with my partner for about 10 years, and then would have an open marriage. So where would I have gotten that? I am serious. I grew up thinking that's what I wanted out of a relationship. As I got older, I realized that it was warped. or you might say I conform to what society says we should be, which is one person. So here's the thing though about
is
cheating.
Is that wrong?
Here's the thing about cheating. I don't think cheating has to do with anything lacking in the marriage or no, there are all those reasons, but I think for somebody to actually make the action and take the action, it has to do with themselves. Because here's the thing, if I'm in a relationship and something is lacking and I want to go and be with somebody else, I'm gonna say to the person that I'm with that this now work for me, my God. You need to have the gumption and the balls and the respect, because if I start to deal with somebody else while I'm dealing with another person, the problem is that person is in a triangle unbeknownst to them. How is that fair? No, grow some balls. Go do what you want to do. Walk out of what you have going on. It's selfish.
But we know a lot of people, and I totally agree with you. I don't agree. I don't, would never stay in a relationship knowing that my partner is cheating on me.
You wouldn't?
And I would not. And I haven't.
Why not?
That's why I...
Why should you?
That's all why right. I'm single. Because I don't think that... I think a man and a woman being together is so precious. And it's so... You know, you've committed to each other. Regardless if you have a ring or not, it's a commitment. I can't bear the thought of my mate being with another woman and then coming back to me to be intimate.
All right,
it doesn't work.
But that is the physical part of it. What about if they were bearing all their, and the next person was, they were bearing witness to another person and all their problems and everything, they would go to this person. Mm-hmm. And I hear a lot of people talk about, oh, I have one friend that I go to with problems. I have one friend that I go to with intimacy problems. I have one friend that I go to. So what about the person at home? What about that going to that person for all that? Because I consider that cheating also, isn't it? Because it's not physical cheating. But you're out there emotional.
But they're probably complaining about that person is part of that problem, correct?
Right. Yeah, there's a thin line, right? Because you need to have an outlet. Like, there's certain things I discuss with girlfriends that I not necessarily going to discuss with my man. But I guess your point is, if there's another man that you're talking to and talking about, because he might just be waiting for, because every relationship has vulnerable moments, right?
Right.
Where you have your ups and your downs. And so that, you know, what is that person's intent that you are communicating with or whatever, you know, because that's a good point, because a one night stand versus having a really good opposite sex friend that you tell him every single thing to, that person takes up your time, right?
Right. So
is that cheating?
For me, it would be a lot harder to swallow. For my mate or spouse or what have you to be in a confidant role or an emotional connected role with somebody else that they never consummated the relationship. You know, this was not a carnal relationship.
Sex.
Everything but
what is that?
Rather than she having a one-night stand. And I know that sounds crazy, but to me it just seems like you give up so much of yourself when you're emotionally attached. That's why I question when you say that I could never be with somebody after they cheated. One thing I've learned in relationships, I never say never, because
you don't know.
Because you know invariably when people cheat, the person who was cheated on, they're not really an innocent party. They're not always an innocent party. I mean, sometimes they are, right? But a lot of times they're not.
But I say never because I've been in that situation. Mm-hmm. And I don't personally care if you did it one time or 10 times. Mm-hmm. You still destroyed a trust that I have. And I'm not a cheater. I won't go out and cheat on you if I'm with you. I would rather break up with you than disrespect you or have to go behind your back to cheat.
So what about
Oh boy, it's coming.
Because when I hear you say that, I hear you guys ever hear someone say, let's just take a break for a while.
No, I ain't taking no break. I ain't taking no break.
You don't take break?
No,
but
somebody
don't
take break.
People use that as an excuse.
Yeah.
And then they come back and say, oh, we weren't together when that happened.
Yeah.
That's BS.
Yeah.
But going back to something you said, Dawn, it's interesting. I think Sean's point about never saying never is, though, even though you've conducted yourself as such in the past,
it's anecdotal.
You don't know if maybe in the future that might change. So it's just life is humbling. But what's interesting is you said something which is the way I want to or don't want to live my life, which is looking over my shoulder by telling a lie. I want to be able to, that if you wake me up 2 a.m. in the morning and ask me the same question, I'm going to get the same answer.
Exactly.
People might not like the truth, but they have to respect the truth. But I was reading something the other day that running around and sneaking around makes the thing exciting.
Yeah.
So some people, while some people don't want to live like that, some people enjoy living like that.
Well, you know what? We're all four different people here.
Right.
Four different personalities, mm-hmm. right? And I think you just have to find what works for you. The person who you're dealing with is a person that you have to be honest with. The cheating partner that come in means that you're breaking some sort of contract or so with that person.
Yeah.
You understand? So if you're going to be the cheater or the cheatee,
cheater,
hey, you know, you have to know who else is in the party and what else is happening and how there's going to be an effect. Some people don't give a crap. They actually, the running around and the exciting thing, some people like the cheating and like, don't care if they get caught because then they just go on to the next one
right.
and so forth.
Right.
So that's another way that you got to look.
Well, the exciting exciting part. It comes along with infidelity. I think that has a lot to do with youth. I could be wrong, but I think it has a lot to do with youth. For myself, I can only speak for myself.
Or immaturity.
Yeah. You know, there are certain things that you do when you're younger. And as you get older, you don't find a need to do it. You don't feel compelled to do it anymore. Let alone, you don't have the memory to do
it. Keep up with the
life. I can't remember all that. No, man. I'm going to tell her last week. Yeah, I can't remember all that things. So, you know, the excitement is one part of it. Yeah. But I wanted to go back to the secular versus the religious impact on relationships. Does it have an impact? You guys have a faith that you adhere to. Right. Has that impacted your view on infidelity?
It is the cornerstone of what your relationship is.
Okay.
No matter what, I don't care who out there. Yeah, everybody's faith is what leads them. Not your faith?
I'm agnostic. It doesn't bother me.
But you have beliefs.
But that's what I'm saying.
But you have beliefs.
But that's
the same thing. You're just calling it a different name. So
but they're more based on relationship and the dynamics of relationship, not really based on code.
But that is still it.
Just respect.
Because you're following a wave pattern.
Yeah.
So that's it. So everybody have somewhat of a wave pattern or something that they do holds steadfast too.
Yeah. Do you agree that some people hide behind it though? Like, do you have some highly religious people who, whether it be cheating or any other unkind or immoral thing, is they just go to church and pray for forgiveness on Sunday?
Yes, like I know that for a fact. I know some church woman.
Yeah, let me tell you, the church girl.
I know that for a fact.
This way go sideways now. Go, I bring up the church girl.
Why you
the
like sideways? Use a sideways shirt.
That's a whole another subject. The whole repressed, on a serious note, the whole repressed behavior or the repressed energy that is endemic to being raised in a highly religious environment. I've seen countless episodes where and we're talking about I can only speak from my experience. You know, girls that have grown up within that environment as they get older, you know, there's certain things that they feel that they left out. So they might spend a longer time being single and just dating for a much longer time. Or they may feel the person that they finally get involved with, you know, they want to explore while they're in that relationship just because of that repressed nature of their faith. You know, but again, this is just my experience. I know maybe you guys have a different experience.
But you know what? Speaking of that, isn't that the person not really being themselves? There's something that, all right, let's say for instance for us, we have this faith, and it has to be something that we totally believe in, that we feel like if we go outside of it, it is just wrong. As opposed to what I was taught when I was growing up. My mom said, you have to go to church and we have to learn these things, and we learn them, and you know you're a good boy if you stick to it.
But those constructs.
But, right. Because inside, behind those walls of what you think, of what you're doing, is not really you. So, what we have to do is dig past that and find out who you really are. Because that too, you might be a cheater. You might be a person who that is
you think
thing.
That's hard-coded into your DNA, being a cheater or not?
Not at all.
No.
Because you know what? Not.
Who am I to say? I've never done a study on it.
But you're saying that you're not being who you really are. Right. So are you, if you're adhering to a certain code or a certain tenets, mm-hmm. then it you could be going against your true nature, then it would be hard-coded as well.
But that is your true nature. Everybody's true nature is to find something to hold on to. Every single person on this planet.
Are you the same way every time, though? Because do you guys agree that different relationships bring out different sides of you?
Yes,
you know, there are people
that's
who
for sure.
Right. There are people who you just bring out a different side. Whether
because
you,
when you think about this, right?
Mm-hmm.
There are some people who have more. You know, we tend to want to follow some people tend to want to follow your sign. Hey, what sign are you? And so forth. You're more bullheaded. You're more this and you're more that. You're more laid back. Oh, you just get away with everything. Oh, you're, you know, you have two different personalities. All this different stuff going on. But let's just get all that out of the way. And let's say whether you believe in that or not, right? You meet someone. The most important thing to you at that point is to learn about this person. See who they are. Even if you're a cheater, even if you're a manipulator, because if you don't know about that person, you don't know how to manipulate them, you don't know how to cheat on them. Or if you're the person who really wants a solid relationship, you still have to learn about that other person. You know pretty much what you're coming with, right? But as you go in, you sort of morph into a different person because of what your intention.
But everybody does that, you're right. How does that affect your tendency to cheat though?
How does it? That's what I was saying. You're either, and I mentioned whether you're a cheater or whether you are not, you know? So I figure most people, this is too boring, or, you know, even some people might even go into the relationship saying, you know what, well, I've been cheating, I'm alive, this time I'm going to go into it, no cheating. As soon as I go into it, that is boring.
I think cheating has to do with insecurity. And coward, being a coward. Because what is a cheater? It's interesting when I hear you say when a person is a cheater, because how do you label somebody a cheater? They just have cheated in every single relationship.
Spots. Cheaters have spots.
Okay, so let me ask you this then. If you're saying this, a cheater is someone who is either coward or what was the one that said either?
I think it's insecurity. I think there are some thirsty people who just need and crave the attention. So any guy who gives them attention, they go bull down the place. Any woman that give them attention, they go and bull down the place. Like, so why not be?
Could it be somebody that is just, that's just a from a male perspective, somebody just an alpha male who seeks just wants power, and he just seeks to conquer. And it's not really about the relationship. He just wants to, once he's gone past there, but it doesn't affect the love that he has for his significant other at home.
But
I'm not saying that can happen. I'm just saying there are people that subscribe to that.
But it come back to exactly what you're saying again with maturity, because I'm gonna tell you, when I was in high school and. I'm a virgin, Bobby, I think. Bobby, yeah, somebody.
You really are calling him.
Yeah, man. So back in that day.
Why did you say Bobby?
So, you know, back in the day, we said, well, you know, high school, you want to check out with a girl, you know?
Yeah.
You're not really going to settle down in no relationship. So, you want to check one girl, if I'm going to say, check a girl. And we used to go party, and when you go to party and you deal with a girl, and think, after a party, you know, remember, phone, we used to call it again, you used to have party line and all that thing.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
You had a lot of time away.
Yeah.
Correct?
Yeah.
Because you didn't have a smartphone. They couldn't call you all the time. I was away from the phone. I was training. I was playing.
Be a dumb phone.
Dumb phone. So back then, there were ways that you could say, well, I'm not talking to this one at this time, but I'm not talking to this one. I'm going to do this, I'm going to do that. But after a while, for some people, after a while, been there, done that, you're like, you know what, hey, alright, you know what, a little bit later in life, I'm going to try this. Same thing. That's not for me.
Yeah.
And you just say, I am not excited by that. It doesn't interest me to do that.
So let me ask this question, though. Do we think that there is a difference, especially in the Caribbean community, when we look at how men cheat versus how women cheat?
Can I address this real quick? Mm-hmm. As far as men, this is what I was going to. I was running across my mind a while ago when Keith was saying this. The name of the show is Caribbean Edge, right? So from a Caribbean perspective and a male perspective, let me just say this. We are a very paternal society. Right? We place a lot of importance on the male, you know, if we're honest, that's what we do, very masculine, you know, society, and that's the way we're brought up, and that comes out in certain ways. in Jamaica, for instance, too, as brought up, is that if you're, you know, as a man, you know, you have X amount of girlfriends. One girlfriend. Man. You need to go and find a girlfriend. Man. You know, these kind of things. It's, you need to go and, I hate to use the term, sow your oats, but, you know, but it really, it means that you need to have X amount of experiences to really understand what you want, what you like, you know, what you enjoy, things like that. And I think that carries on. How long it lasts in a man's life, you know, it's completely on them. But I think that is what leads to the infidelity, because there's a need. I don't feel like a man. I just want a man. How long? No, sir. I touch road.
But we brought that Caribbean mentality, or what you just described, into today's world, so to speak, because I had an event at my home. And I had two young adults there, and they're dating each other. And a Caribbean older person said to the young adults, these are 18, 19-year-olds, and said, because the person is rather tall, basketball superstar potential, and said to him, you know, how many women you have? And his girlfriend's right there. Wow. And I think so the messenger said, and he addressed him. He's like, "Look, this is my girl. What are you talking about?" Because at this stage in their life, they're not into that mentality. It's not for them. He was probably 50-something years old.
No, the young man.
The young, he was like 19.
All right. So hold on. No, I hear this all the time. So you can't date a bunch of men at the same time. This woman, she can't have a whole bunch of men she dating at the same time.
It's girls, right. 18-year-old girl.
Alright, this girl can't have a bunch of men she dating at the same time. Or this young man can't have a bunch of girls he's dating at the same time. But yet still, I've heard tons of my friends who are parents said, don't settle down with that guy. Just, you know, you're too young. Mm-hmm. But it's okay for that relationship to be over and going to another one, so there's a lot in between, right?
18, they're in love, first relationship, and we're projecting, or this person was projecting to them his thoughts. Hey, because you're a basketball player, where you're a woman.
Was it because he's a basketball player, or is it because he's a male?
They were fascinated that he was he's a basketball player. That was the fascination. So it comes with the assumption you must have enough woman, and you know, here he is with a beautiful young lady, and an older person that should be more mature is sending that message, and this is a Caribbean man talking to two
American
students.
I agree with him. I wouldn't have said it in front of his girlfriend, but I do agree with him, and I think that's a problem with youngsters these days, and I think it was a problem when I was that age. I think it was a problem when even the generation before mine. I think that's a problem, is that we've put them in a situation where they have to conform to marital restraints within a casual relationship. You cannot have a 17 or 18-year-old kids that are dating and then not saying it's a problem for them to go out with somebody else. I think it's healthy. If it was my daughter or my son, I would welcome them seeing somebody else going out to dinner. And keep in mind, I'm thinking about this and assuming that this is just dating, right? So you date one person on Monday, then Friday evening come, then you go to another friend. Then.
I don't think that was the situation. No,
so you're saying
you're saying what I was just saying.
Yeah, I think it's important.
Right, which is in this in this situation, this is you at an event, and as
a mature person,
you walk up to a couple that you don't know, and you portray, man, you must have enough woman. But that goes to that Caribbean mentality where it's you must have enough woman, and he wasn't afraid to say in front of someone else. So going back to the question, which is, you know, why are women viewed differently in the Caribbean when they cheat versus a man cheating. So the woman is referred to all the vulgar names out there.
That is true.
A slut, a bee, everything else. Yeah. Versus a man where it's you got your stripes.
That's very true, Don.
You know, just missing here, we need somebody from a different, from a younger generation, because I would challenge that notion that you say about the way a woman is looked upon. I don't think it's as severe as you think it is. I think it's more accepted. Within a younger generation.
But we're talking about our generation.
Slowly it's changing. As a person who works with kids all the time, and I'm working with both the girls' team and the boys' team, it's totally different, but the same fundamental hurt from when that person is not giving you the attention is there. So if you're talking, if I see kids in the high school, and once these two are talking, they want to know why you're talking to that one next week.
See, that's a problem.
Too much focus on that.
But isn't this where communication come in then, as far as like, I don't know anything about the younger generation. I was worried when you said that earlier, and I figured it would go sideways, because that generation, it don't matter whether you're boy, girl, boy and girl, all kind of thing going on.
Well, that too, but it is what it is.
Yeah, but I think in any generation, which is this communication, right, it's key. What is this? What are the expectations? And have that open. You need to, first of all, know who you are. Mm-hmm. Know what you like, what you don't like, what you want, what you don't want, and have those conversations.
So as I've matured into who I am today, I think very strongly that I can say, if I'm with someone and I found out that they had another partner, whether it's mainly sexual, that I would walk away, because I know within myself that I don't need someone that can disrespect me, that can share something so intimate, and I am willing to walk away from any relationship.
So stabbing first or after?
He's not even worth the stab, and the other woman is definitely not worth the argument or the fight that women fight over.
Yeah.
If someone calls me and they say, hey, this is my man, whatever, I'm like, okay, no problem. And I'm going to have it out with the dude, not with the girl. I'm going to let him know, look, this stops right here. Because I'm not gonna fight for you. I don't need to fight for you, because guess what? I'm drop dead gorgeous. I don't need to. I work, I'm independent. I need someone that can come to me and enhance
you,
me and build a life with me. And if I'm not demanding that at this stage in my life, then something's wrong.
Yeah. So what happens if somebody don't have all them attributes and they're not drop dead gorgeous and stuff like that?
But you still have to have your own confidence in yourself.
Well, I'm a should be a six, you know, deserve
nobody. No, but it's about self-esteem and confidence, right? It don't have nothing to do with how you look. It's how you perceive yourself, how you carry yourself. But yeah, I think what you're saying is you command this, you want this, you're looking for a partner, you're not looking for a
I think every woman should feel like you, Don.
Thank you. I don't want somebody else's man.
It should be tolerated. My only thing is, your thinking, I agree with it. I think you should enter any relationship with that outlook. But I think it's many things can happen.
I know. I agree with you.
Well, you know what, boy? I tell you, this could go on forever.
We're
probably what 4 minutes in it.
I got so much stuff.
Maybe we have another episode. So let's ask everyone the question to give your final thoughts. I gave mine. So Keith. How you feel about cheating and what you expect for yourself. I think that's a good way. And then we'll ask our audience to chime in and leave their comments.
Definitely. I don't deal with that. Yes.
Black and white, I don't deal with it.
Boom.
Well, as I mentioned, I grew up in a dysfunctional family. And so my thoughts on relationship, they truly were warped. But as I got older and I matured, I was in a relationship where I did cheat once. And then subsequent relationships I've chosen not to, because I realized that it's selfish. it's immature, which hopefully too will lead to the next subject. You don't want to be with multiple people. You run the risk of sexually transmitted diseases. You run the risk of getting shot. You run the
I'm getting stabbed.
You
getting
chopped on, right? You hurt
getting run over.
All kidding aside though, where I am now, what I will tell you, and my friends have heard me say this, that if money were no object, I'd have a spread of a property. And my man would live in one wing and I would live in the other wing, and we would continue to court each other. Just the same the same things that go into
what
getting
a beautiful concept.
Are getting me where you dress up for a date, or you don't assume I'm available tonight. I might be with my girlfriend, or you sneak into my room and some little looky go on. You know, just I would want to keep I would want to keep that courtship going, but absolutely no cheating, unacceptable, and will not tolerate.
Mr. Spaulding.
Sean Spaulding.
No, I was thinking about who was spread with the wing over there. Well, I was seeing with pennies. I want a wing like that.
So where are you at this stage in your life?
I don't. My memory can't take it. Fun and joke aside, I don't see the need for it. You know, I'd much rather have work on a more fulfilling relationship, work on that, put all my energies into that, and have that blossom into something that is, you know, something I can look on and say, I'm proud of this. You know, look at the fruits that that have come from this, mm-hmm. You know, and I enjoy the person that I'm with, you know. I think there's value in that, and there's growth in that. I found that since that has been my focus to be loyal and be fully focused in my relationship, I've grown as a person.
Yeah.
So it there's extremities to it, you know. And so again, it comes back to the maturity. But I must add this caveat that people that it's difficult for them and they cannot be in a monogamous relationship. Some people carry on like that and it's perfectly fine for them. There is somebody out there for you.
There's
somebody out there for you. Let's not forget that. There's somebody out there for you. Some people like that.
Yeah, some people are thirsty.
It's just, you know, it's your cup of tea. Sip, sip.
Once again, thanks for tuning in to another episode of The
Brilliant Edge. Remember to like, share, subscribe, follow us on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter.
And thank you, panel, for being honest and open and sharing with us.
Right.
Bye.
And sip. Don't forget to sip.
That
looked like a spliff, Bridget.
Yeah, spliff and spliff. What? Okay, spliff and sip.
Spliff and sip.
Spliff and sip.
Hey! Banging on the bathroom floor. How could I forget that I had given her an extra fee? All this time she was standing there, she never took her eyes off me.
Oh, you bring the woman access to your villa. Just for son of weakness, all of your cleaner, your pillar. You better watch your back before she turn into a killer. Let's review the situation that you call the pinna. To be a true player, you have to know how to play. If she say a night, convince her say a day. Never admit to a word where she say. And if she claim a tell her baby, no way.
But she caught me on the counter.
Wasn't me.
Saw me banging on the sofa.
Wasn't me.
I even had her in the shower.
Wasn't me.
She even caught me on